Hello viewers, I'm Kamara Daniel, a clinical nutritionist from Nutrition Rehabilitation Center Kampala. Today I want to talk about as age goes, usually these people are usually neglected. But there is what we call geriatric nutrition, where these elderly people need good nutrition because they are aging. So what can we do to ensure these people have good and quality diet so that actually they can maintain their elderly age in a very healthy lifestyle? So nutrition geriatrics is very, very tricky because usually these elderly people may try to like some food and try to eat some food due to some little conditions according to the aging period. So nutrition geriatrics calls us as people who stay with these elderly people, as caretakers, as guardians, to make sure these elderly people are taken care of. Number one is that to make sure these elderly people meet the dietary requirements every day. For example, make sure they meet a dietary requirement of a carbohydrate. They also need a balanced diet. So when we talk about a carbohydrate, it means these people, they also need energy, because at one point they use energy depending on the age category. Because these people, sometimes you find they want to do their own work and they need carbohydrate enriched diets. They go foods to make sure they're able to go and do their own work. And also their body also demands that energy so that it can properly function. Number two, we shall talk about carbohydrates. Ensure these adults, elderly adults, get the protein energy foods. It is very, very important for them to find both low-density lipoproteins and high-density lipoproteins. For example, red meat and white meat, considerably taking it in a considerable manner to make sure it is not over diet. Ensuring it is not over diet in elderly is very, very important. So making sure that these elderly patients get proteins is very, very key, because the tissues need to be repaired as they are aging. So examples of proteins that these elderly patients need, number one, they can be beans, can also have ground nuts, also have meat, can be red or white, also have fish, also have fish of all types has proteins, fish of all types contain proteins. Can also talk about and other very many sources of proteins. Most especially these elderly people need what we call vitamins and minerals, because they need immunity a lot. For example, these elderly people are prone to diseases, so once they don't meet the dietary requirements of vitamins and minerals, it will be a disservice. So encourage, as you're aging, increase the intake of fruits, increase the intake of vegetables, increase the intake of water, increase the intake of salads, because they are the only sources of vitamins and minerals. And also we encourage them to decrease the intake of processed foods in elderly clients, in elderly people. We discourage the intake of processed products. The processed products, they are not healthy for aging adults. Another thing is that these vitamins and minerals, of course, you all know the sources, all fruits, you also know all the fruits, also know the vegetables, also know water, among other sources. We really encourage them to have a complete balanced diet to make sure their processes are properly functioning in the body. For women who have reached menopause or the period of not experiencing the menstrual blood per month, we encourage them take these minerals a lot, because they are very important in balancing your hormones. Actually, they make your body feel good, and you may not get postmenopausal syndrome, which is very, very common in such ages. Then also the common condition, they are bone pains in elderly. So we also encourage them They will take foods rich in calcium. Foods rich in calcium are most encouraged. For example, dairy products can take milk, can take cheese, can take ghee. All those ones contain calcium. Can also take other sources of calcium. Can also make sure that your body is healthy through doing some little exercises of elderly people. Take for example, you've cleaned the house, you've done some chore. That's an exercise. You don't need to first run 3 kilometers. So in elderly, we encourage a balanced dieting that mainly comprises of vitamins and minerals, proteins, and to a lesser carbohydrate. And also encourage proper food handling to ensure there's no food spoilage that reduces food poisoning. Because these people, as I had earlier said, they are prone to infections because of the low immunity they are going to. So we encourage the intake of a balanced diet and making sure that their food is properly handled during preparation.